The Finns, Billy Pelton into the front of the net. There's Gerber with a nice save, and Gerber will have to be excellent, Greg Millen, if the Swiss are going to stage an upset here against the Finns.
Well, without question already, two big saves by Gerber as Jokinen, who is a terrific goal scorer. We all know that, goes right to the net, and a little chip shot out in front, and there's Gerber, who makes the first big save of the hockey game, and you're right, Jim, he will have to do many of those tonight. And you mentioned the way the Swiss national team like to get on the body much more. There's a good example of it there as Fischer gives Jokinen a pretty good ride into the boards for the first good solid check of the hockey game.
Saku Koivu, Teppo Newman, and shot. Gerber could see it all the way, and he made a nice save.
Well, I like Gerber here early. I mean, a couple of things that he's doing so well. A, he's finding pucks through traffic. And B, not only that, he's not letting any rebounds out whatsoever. Timo Salani, who was very good in the World Cup of Hockey, then, of course, had his knee surgery, has been even better in the National Hockey League since coming back from the surgery. And there's what I mean. Look at Gerber. No rebound whatsoever, and he sees the puck all the way through. And Vixer here with a pretty nice little rush and a turnover right at the blue line. And you don't see the Finnish national team do that very often, but that caused a very good scoring chance for the Swiss on that play.
Thomas Ziegler that time was a centerman who just pulled right back and checked the man in front. Here's Billy Pelton, and took a pass and took a shot that just went wide of the net. Shot by Jokinen. He scores. Olli Jokinen. In and out in a hurry, and some of these players aren't even sure if there's been a goal scored, but Olli Jokinen has the first goal of the game on a Finnish power play.
Oh, there's no question this went in, and what a great release by Olli Jokinen on the far side after the puck came off the boards in an awkward fashion. And it's a shot that's missed, and it comes right back out. And Jokinen, the late man, doesn't get picked up, and he just blasts it right by Gerber. And it actually went off. It looked like the defenseman's stick and then went in. And the ref, right away, as you can see by our ref cam, says goal. We'll have one more look at the goal. Olli Jokinen with that terrific release. That's why he has 25 goals in the National Hockey League. A missed shot, and Gerber was trying to play the puck coming off the boards, and it just skated away from him. And that's why he never was in position at all for that second chance and hit a stick on the way in, mind you, and beat him.
New York Rangers' Ville Niemann, and turns, fires. Gerber makes the save, and he hangs on as his feet are knocked out from underneath him by Jarkko Ruutu.
Now, this is a temporary facility here. Actually, the ice is built on sand, and the boards are temporary. In fact, the seats we're sitting in are temporary, as this is an exhibition hall. They've had trouble with the ice today as we look at Gerber going on his rear end after some traffic in front in the season for the Carolina Hurricanes. As we look at Ruutu, we don't see him do that much in the National Hockey League. I think he may end up in his rear, but here's Salani going to the net. He does that a lot. And Gerber, with a terrific read, is over well before the pass, and that's why he's able to make a very good save on that play.
Lindenbacher, there's the shot on Niedimäki, whose positioning has been perfect so far in this game, and he made an easy save and held on.
It's been perfect, but all the shots have been from the outside. And Pettinen here gets all tied up with Gerber. As you can see, he was pushed in, but he didn't make any attempt to get out of the way, and that might have been a penalty.
It's Saku Koivu, Jari Lehtinen. Numanen takes a pass, takes a shot, he scores! Great shot from Teppo Numanen, and the Finns have a 2-0 lead.
Well, that's what you have to do against Gerber, who's a butterfly goalie, and he's always butterfly first. He's not a hybrid goalie. He will use the butterfly even before the shot takes off of sticks. And Newman with a great pass as he finds Teppo Newman here, and what a shot. I mean, what a shot right over top of Gerber. And you can see his head is up, and he's thinking high all the way.
He's wide open at this point, isn't he?
Is he ever? He ends up inside almost at the faceoff dot. As again, the Swiss have been collapsing all game long, killing penalties, and perhaps the Finns talked about it between periods, saying, look, our points are open, use them. They'll be able to walk right in. Teppo Newman did just that. And here's the good chance, the only good chance by Seager here in the slot. And Niedermäki does an excellent job of skating on his knees and get in position. But, man, Ziegler, like many of the Swiss team, are a fairly physical group. There's some nice contact on Salo by Ziegler.
Olli Jokinen in front. Quick shot. He scores. Jokinen from Peltonen. 3-0 Finland. 3 power play goals.
And that's been the difference in this hockey game. 5-on-5, the Swiss have been hanging around, but they just can't seem to keep up to the Finns in the neutral zone, and those hooks and holes and grabs have been really costing them. And Jokinen here, watch him drift right to the slot. He'll push off his defenseman and then drift into position, and Strait lets him go. And Strait is looking at the puck instead of perhaps pushing off a little bit with his check. And there is Jokinen nicely pushing off Strait and putting the one-timer right to Martin Gerber. A 60-footer there without anybody even close to the front of the net. You know, it was interesting. I talked to Timo Salani at the last World Championships, and he was playing very well, and he said, I'm not going back to the National Hockey League unless I'm healthy and get my knee fixed. Well, during the lockout, he got his knee fixed. Well, the Finns obviously have more skill. It's becoming obvious.
Saku Koivu centering, and Timo Salani scores. There's the skill level you talked about. Salani from Koivu, 4-0 Finns.
And you just can't give Salani that much room in that scoring area. If you do, the end result will be just that, a goal. And the Swiss have been getting off the body a little bit here and getting into the spectators. Both defense went for the puck behind the net, and Salani starts the playoff. Give and go. It's such a great, important part of hockey, and this is an excellent example of it. You give it, you go to the net, and you shoot it, and you get it back.
And at 4-0, not much of a celebration of the goal.
This will show you a little give and go here by Salani. There's to Koivu. Now watch the defenders. They're pretty good there, but then, whoop, away goes Sager to chase Koivu, and that left Mr. Salani wide open in front. And this year here with that one chance that almost snuck through, it was a rolling puck, and it just snuck through the arm and the body of Nita Mäki, and then as you can see, he got enough of it.
A stop in play with 3 minutes to go in this period. 4-0 is the score for Finland. Finns with a goaltender out for the extra attacker. There's a quick shot by Lehtinen. Rebound. Salani scores. They won't have to serve the penalty. Teemu Salani has his second. It's 5-0 for the Finns.
And defensively is where the Swiss are having all kinds of problems now. They're missing assignments. They're leaving players open. Gerber kicks out the rebound. He hasn't done that very often. And here's the initial shot, but it's in a good scoring position. As you can see, everybody's watching the puck for the Swiss. And Salani has a gift on the backhand as he just chips it over top of Gerber, who has absolutely no chance on that play. And we'll take one more look at Salani. Just cruises behind the net. There he is to the left of your screen, and that's how he loses the Swiss defense, then backs away from the puck. Great goal scorers will do that. And when you get across as a goaltender on these kind of plays, you're ahead of the puck. You're ahead of the pass. And this is a nice read here. Abishir's ahead of the pass, and that's why he's able to pick this one right out of the air on Jokinen, who is looking for his hat trick in this game. Abishir's saying, guess what? There's two of us here, and I want to be the number one guy in this Olympic Games.
The Finns score 3 on the power play, 1 on a delayed penalty, and their skill took over in those situations, and they put the Swiss away 5-0.
Give the Swiss an A for effort for their work ethic, the way they tried and got on the body early and tried to compete with the Finns, but at the end of the day, they just weren't good enough, period.